You're back on the rundown. The Philippine Navy Special Investigating Committee recently completed its probe on the case of retired Marine Colonel Generoso Mariano. Mariano was shown on video talking about soldiers' hardships and defending their right to revolt against the government if injustice is committed. Investigators found no sufficient evidence to charge Mariano for mutiny and instead recommended charges for violating several articles of war, including disrespect towards the president. Meanwhile, the Navy's new purchase, a Hamilton-class warship renamed the BRP Gregorio del Pilar, will be fitted with additional capabilities. The ship was bought from the U.S. and will help the Navy protect the country's sovereignty in the disputed Spratly Islands. For our discussion tonight on various issues facing the Philippine Navy, we're joined in the studio by its Flag Officer in Command, Vice Admiral Alexander Pama. You can join our discussion, send in your comments through Twitter using the hashtag Rundown. Good evening, sir. Welcome to the show.
Good evening, sis.
I think the proper greeting would be welcome aboard.
Thank you very much. Yeah.
Our ship. Our ABS-CBN news.
The BRP Rundown.
BRP Rundown. Thank you.
Doesn't sound good for the Navy.
Who had the choice of why Gregorio del Pilar?
Well, the process of selecting the name goes through a certain process. We have a board for that. Uh-huh. And I'd like to make it clear at this point that the name Gregorio del Pilar right now is still provisional.
I see. Oh.
It has to go through a process and it has to be approved all the way to the president. And that has not been undertaken yet.
So what are the names of the ships so far that we have in the Navy?
We have a number of them already, but primarily it's named after heroes.
Yeah. Do we have a Jose Rizal?
In our Navy fleet? Yeah, before there used to be. Mostly for warships. We name this after heroes.
But Gregorio del Pilar is a worthy name.
Hindi ka tulad sa US, mga former presidents na yung mga pangalan ng mga...
Yeah, considering the number of ships, I think they've run out of heroes to name.
And then they
definitely have a lot of ships.
Yeah. Hopefully we get into that situation. But this is not the first. It won't be the last, rather.
We are hoping that it's not going to be the last. In fact, discussions are in progress right now that hopefully we can get the second and the third one. Mm-hmm. And we do have the resources for that. We do have the funds for that, thanks to the government. Mm-hmm. And right now, it's not a question of just wanting it. We are negotiating this right now with the United States government.
Already.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So we're not actually thinking of getting them free, right? Because we were thinking that with our U.S.-Philippine Mutual Defense Treaty, yung mga excess articles of war na tinatawag nila be provided to us.
Not entirely free. Because for example, this one, we did pay the U.S. government transfer cost about $10 million.
Yes.
And plus we had to pay for the training of our people. Mm-hmm. We sent 95 of our officers and men, and most of them trained for about 5 months before we actually took possession of this warship that we have now. Mm-hmm.
But you'll be outfitting the ship, you know, with our own equipment. Philippine Navy, kumbaga yung communications equipment, and what else?
Yes, Tony. When we took possession of the ships, the United States Coast Guard had to take out some of the equipment in it because these are what you call non-releasable to other countries. Ah. And we do also have our own requirements on the different equipment that we're going to put in it. Mm-hmm. And of course, I cannot discuss what these are in public, but we definitely have to do that.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. To those who are concerned that, you know, explain first why this choice? Why did you choose this particular model? To those who are concerned that it seems old, pinaglumaan, iniitsapwera na ng Amerika.
Okay, two points. Yes. One, why this kind of a ship? Mm-hmm. It's the biggest ship that we have right now. Mm-hmm. It's primarily for a purpose that we can use this kind of a ship in areas where we could not go to.
Okay.
The environment where the ship is operating are exactly those areas na dati hindi natin napapatrulyahan.
Okay.
So that's the reason for the size of the ship.
So hindi dapat kalakihan. naman, hindi naman kailangan yung talagang sobrang...
Not super big yes. naman, but big enough to be able to withstand the different sea state, okay. mm-hmm. which our present inventory of ships cannot do.
Okay.
So we now just have to fill in the gap insofar mm-hmm. as that operational requirement is concerned.
Okay.
Now, on the context, on the other question that you had...
It's no longer...
Yung kalumaan.
Opo.
Okay. The reason being value for money. Mm-hmm. If we're going to order a brand new warship now, two things. One, we're going to take delivery of this 3 years from now.
Mm-hmm.
And then number two, the cost.
Mm-hmm. Would have cost how many times more?
A lot more. Because like, the size of a ship like that, a brand new one, mm-hmm. would basically cost about 4 billion pesos.
Oh,
that's bare. No,
we're paying
no
like
weapons.
450 million pesos.
This one, we got it for 450 million pesos. Okay. So, and it...
So, ilang billion ulit, sir?
4 billion pesos.
Wow. Okay.
And that's a very conservative estimate.
Mm-hmm.
And what's more important is we need a step up kind of a ship. You don't buy a brand new thing for purposes of our people, mm-hmm. gaining the expertise, mm. the knowledge, pagpapraktisan muna natin.
Too much too soon.
Too much too soon. And not okay. only that. And again, you spend a lot of money for a brand new ship, wherein our people, the learning curve mm. of our people is still there.
Mm-hmm.
So it definitely serves the purpose right now mm-hmm. na pinagpapraktisan natin.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the same time, it addresses the operational requirements okay. of that area.
So it's really mm-hmm. apt for
oh,
our
definitely.
Needs. Yes.
There's no doubt about that.
Okay. Operational requirements. Because, of course, we all know that we have one of the longest coastlines. When you take the islands all together in this part of the world, and what we need are maybe patrol craft just to make sure na walang nakakalusot sa mga borders natin. Would the Gregorio del Pilar be functioning the same way that we'd be guarding the coastline or parang helping to interdict intruders?
It would be complementary to our existing inventory right now. We have fairly enough smaller ships to address precisely that kind mm-hmm. of concern.
Okay.
But we do have a gaping gap mm-hmm. insofar as patrolling the areas that demands bigger ships.
Okay. So farther out into our
yeah, it's going to be complementary territory. As well as supplementary for the smaller ships and the bigger ships.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a question of mutually the defeating thing.
Uh-oh.
It's not a question either or.
Mm-hmm. Mutually exclusive.
Mm-hmm. It's not mutually exclusive. Mm-hmm. It's definitely
but we need. Sorry to interrupt, sir, but we do understand there are only about seven floating assets in the West Philippine Sea that you have right now.
I will neither confirm the exact figures, but it's not...
Not much.
It's not that much, and we still need for us to be able to address the big area of concern that we have out there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But before you can actually send it out to patrol the West Philippine Sea, there'll be some work that has to be done.
Oh, yes.
Okay,
like, for example,
that.
We talk yeah. of Del Pilar right now. Definitely after the ceremonies... when we receive this tomorrow,
mm-hmm.
we would need we would have to put it on dry dock.
Okay.
Repainting is a definite must.
Mm-hmm.
It's the color of the ship right now is white, coming mm-hmm. from the Coast Guard of mm-hmm. the United States.
Mm-hmm.
We have to paint it to regulation haze gray.
Okay.
And then some minor repairs that have to be undertaken. It's not much difference from having a car driving all the way from Lawag to Bicol.
Mm-hmm.
Kahit sa pag-tune up na lang, you need to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So these are the minor things and mm-hmm. some minor repairs on its hull, piping. So
that will take how long?
The estimate right now, based on the work estimate to be done, maybe about a month mm-hmm. or so. Mm-hmm. And after that, she's ready.
This must be, a mad scramble among your men to get assigned to the Gregorio del Pilar.
Yes.
Everybody wants to.
Yes, practically, yes, but not everybody can be there.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. For one, the Navy basically is manned by people with different expertise.
Mm.
And at least from among those with ratings that would apply to that kind of a ship, mm-hmm. they went through a very rigorous process. The selection process was done to include psychological mm-hmm. part of it. And we continue to screen people to be able to be assigned to those kinds of ships that we have.
It is a beauty. This was taken sir, before she set sail for the Philippines.
Yeah,
no?
I think
he set sail.
She.
Oh, she. You always
in military parlance, vessels are always
ships are always called
she.
She.
Okay. Yeah, before
was
she
this
set
in where was this, sir?
If I'm not mistaken,
Alameda,
it was in Alameda, in Alameda. California.
Okay, so she'll have to respond to challenges, obviously,
yes,
to our territorial sovereignty. In this case, would there be any other support ships traveling with her, or mag-isa lang talaga siya when she's out at sea?
Well, when we send her to deployment, it depends on again on the mission that she's going to undertake.
Yeah.
There would be times she would be in tandem or she would be in a with a group.
Yeah.
And there would be times she will have to do it by herself.
Mm-hmm.
Again, as we were mentioning earlier, her capacity and capability to go through different sea states,
yeah,
the other ships may not be able to hack it.
Ah, okay.
So she will have to go it alone.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But in some areas, we still do a lot of operations wherein they go either in tandem or as a task group.
Okay.
And the president will be there tomorrow.
Yes,
in the ceremony.
He will be, and thanks to the president because he's primarily the one instrumental in acquiring the ship.
You know, it's funny because coming at this time, we're going to receive the Gregorio del Pilar,
and he's going to China.
Yeah? And the Chinese are already testing their first aircraft here.
I know.
So it's like
it's just an indication of
how far
we are.
It's not actually a question of trying to outdo each other. For one, definitely we don't have the resources to join, and we have no intentions of joining the arms race anyway.
Yes.
But then again, yeah, it's a question of the credible deterrence that we can put, we can have in areas where we definitely as our sovereignty is beyond question.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There's no plan, I guess, for an ASEAN joint maritime task group, is there?
Not in the context of conducting operations, but some ideas have been floated from among the ASEAN chiefs of Navy for maybe for training and exercises. We did actually have some discussions on this last month during the first ASEAN meeting in Hanoi, and it's part of the confidence building measures that can be done. It's in the realm of the possibility right now.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, aside from deploying or acquiring all these floating assets, sir, there's also the you have to upgrade or a radar system. No, does it come in tandem?
Yes, not only the radar, but I think suffice it to say that we will need to upgrade the communications, electronics, and other parts of the suite. We call it the suite.
Okay, okay.
One of the jobs or the functions that she will do when she gets out there, she will definitely increase our capability for what we call the domain awareness.
Mm-hmm.
The monitoring system, of course, the presence, the deterrence, and all those stuff. Of course, I cannot talk about the details.
Okay.
But
okay.
Then again, it will have a multi-role and a multi-function when we send her out there.
Mm-hmm. Okay. With this warship, what else is in your shopping list? What will follow? So another one, perhaps.
Yes.
As
I was mentioning earlier, in the discussions that we're having right now. Mm-hmm. Maybe a couple is in the realm of the probable already.
And a couple more?
Yeah, a couple more, hopefully. Because it's not a question of having a list.
Mm-hmm.
It's a question of what would fit into the strategy that we would want to be done there.
Okay.
So as I was mentioning, maybe a couple more. And based on your question, the other attendant capabilities that would conform
that
with the strategy
that would support
the Hamilton, because the Hamilton will only form part of a bigger system in the defense and in the strategy that we're having. So yung Hamilton is only one of the components.
Do you think we'll ever need submarines?
Well, maybe not in my professional lifetime, but the need will always be there. But on the question of the capacity and the capability of our government having it right now, I think it's not yet appropriate.
Because the Malaysians actually bought submarines.
Yes.
Oh, and it's a big scandal for them.
It's a big scandal there.
Because
yeah.
They don't need submarines, right? I mean, the kind of geography they have.
No, with due respect to my counterparts out there, I wouldn't want to comment whether everybody has his own kind of worldview of the threats and all those things. And again, with due respect to my counterparts, I respect whatever.
But it's great that we have this prior to the president's visit to China. I mean, at least you know there's something to brag about.
We can tell
if at all. I wouldn't want to venture on something that's way beyond my pay scale. but then again, if at all the message that is sent here, not only for one particular country, but maybe for the whole world, is that we mean what we're saying. Insofar as us are concerned in the Navy, we have a mandate to perform, and we will perform it.
You mentioned that the president was really instrumental in getting this ship here. How was that done? I mean, we've had Malampaya for a long time. The idea of tapping, you know, the revenue from the oil exploration, or rather oil extraction in Palawan.
This simply shows, I think, the president's will. At the very outset, he was saying the armed forces, and particularly the Navy, needs help insofar as upgrading. I'm not even talking of modernizing, upgrading the capability.
So this is not modernizing, upgrading.
Not yet. We are upgrading. So when I assumed command in January, the president said at that point that he is going to help the Navy in the modernization program. And what? It's just 7 months, 8 months, 8 months for that matter. And we have physically this ship here in Manila. If that's not...
You didn't think that would have been, possible?
Seeing the sincerity of the president when he the subsequent actions and the directives that he gave after that thing, I had no doubt that we will get it within the year. Of course, in the context of us here in the Philippines, because at a certain time when the United States already said, okay, you can have this, it was a matter of time.
Plus, we paid for it. This is not something that they're giving us. You know, it's not like a hand-me-down.
Yes, although admittedly...
In a sense.
But we're paying.
But we're paying for it.
Yeah, admittedly, the price is a bargain.
Okay.
But it's just like the NP helicopters. They're not exactly brand new.
What? Don't compare that.
Okay, let's not go there. You know, we did introduce Admiral Pama in our interview by way of also talking about other issues were also being handled by the Navy. We're talking about Colonel Generoso Mariano, of course.
Yeah.
The investigation into his... videotaped statement has ended.
Yes,
and there are no charges of mutiny being planned against him.
No. The results of the special investigation committee has already been submitted to me, and I think it's public knowledge. The findings of the committee was he is liable. He's liable to be charged with three violations of three articles of war, and one article of war in the revised penal code. Which is article of war number 62 for disrespect to the president, article of war 91 for provocative speeches, article of war 96 for conduct unbecoming of an officer and a gentleman. And if I'm not mistaken, he's also liable for article 142 in the revised penal code.
And he's still detained.
He's restricted to quarters right now.
He will just have to undergo court-martial proceedings.
That would depend because the case is now... He will be undergoing a pretrial investigation. there is a process.
I see. And then that pre-trial investigation
would determine if there is sufficiency of evidence for the case to prosper into a court-martial proceedings.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that his statements have somehow maybe elicited some kind of support within the Navy, or within the ranks of the armed forces? What do you think?
I don't think so. Mm-hmm. Not at all. Mm.
You know, in the Manila Times today, what the headline was, another de-stab attempt, supposedly, against the president. Are there really serious attempts within the AFP?
No. Mm-hmm. Straight face, I can say none. Mm-hmm. Mm.
And Mariano was just acting, egged on by some... civilians.
I wouldn't want to comment on that, just because I am the one responsible for making recommendations or making approving, and it might affect the ongoing investigations. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Okay, on another issue, on the supposed involvement of some officers in the 2004 elections, the Mayuga report was just declassified. Well, I guess he headed that. Because he was Inspector General, I think, at that time. But do you see a need for the AFP to investigate, to open up the case, or should you, do you want it left to other government bodies?
On a personal opinion, I'd rather that other government agencies do that. Mm-hmm. I think to a certain extent, you can say that the AFP has gone through some sort of a catharsis on these things. Mm-hmm. There was a Mayuga report that had been made, conducted, and then now, as you were saying, with being come out, we need to do our job already. Mm-hmm. If indeed there were things that happened, let the proper government agencies do that. Mm-hmm. And we would rather continue doing our work and our mandate and not be distracted with these things, which has happened so many years back. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And you know, up to this day, I think one other case that still haunts the Navy would be the case of Ensign Philip Castaño. Mm-hmm. In that case in particular, had given rise to suspicions that there have been some incidents of smuggling where Navy personnel were involved, and up to this day, of course, that hasn't been proven. Although it still somehow lingers that there's that kind of perception na nagagamit po yung ilang mga Navy assets for smuggling.
Yeah, as you were saying, perceptions and suspicions. But the thing is, in a society like ours, we have the court system, we have the justice system.
Yeah.
I think the best judge to that is let it be brought to the proper venue, which is the Court of Justice.
Mm-hmm. So it has to be a civilian court and not the military establishment that
investigates. Well, it was part of the complaint against Merceditas Gutierrez.
Yeah, because if I'm not mistaken, it has gone through investigations in the Senate and all other
the UN
venues.
Had,
In the other venues. Mm. But maybe we can put this thing in finality by bringing it to court. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Like you said, you have urgent business to attend to. Yeah. Guarding the West Philippine Sea is, of course,
not only the West Philippine Sea. Yeah. We are a maritime nation. Mm-hmm. We are an archipelago. Mm-hmm. There are lots of areas that we still need to guard. Mm-hmm. We are not even talking of the eastern seaboard of the Philippines.
Right.
And funny, because in last a few days ago, when we were flying in from Guam, gabi na to, and we were a few minutes away from Manila, and I was looking outside the porthole of the airplane, and I see a lot of light boats in the Pacific Ocean, which is very near, and I'm sure was already inside our exclusive economic zone.
You mean like fishing?
Fishing, boats. Definitely. They have these light boats to attract the ships.
Yeah.
And looking down, I thought it was a city. with a number
so
of that's indicative.
And obviously hindi Pilipino yung mga yun.
Obviously, because the ang sadami is ang lalaki. And that more or less gave me the conviction now that that's another area wherein we're losing a lot.
Yes.
And we masama yung loob po dahil that could have been part of our job to secure that area, and we still cannot do it.
Yeah. Well, this is a
and
start.
But thank God we now start to have the Hamilton, and this is the kind of ships that we can send over to the eastern seaboard makakaya niya na yung malalaking alon doon. And hopefully, as we go on, we can now say guard that area which is ours.
Hindi naman po siguro classified yung technical capability ni Gregorio Del Pilar. Say you set sail from Philippine Navy headquarters, how fast could you reach, say, Basilan or Sulu?
That depends because that's the beauty of this ship. Ang propulsion po nito is what we call the CODOG. Combination of diesel or gas.
CODOG, okay.
CODOG, C-O-D-O-G.
Combination diesel or gas. Okay.
Combination diesel or gas. It has two kinds of propulsion system, the machinery. If you're just doing the normal patrols, you don't need speed.
Okay. See, diesel ka?
You go diesel, okay. And then you just, sped about 1,000 or
parang
so liters liters per hour. But
when the urgent ang mission.
When there's a necessity and the situation demands, then you need to have what you call a spurt speed.
You switch to gas.
You switch to the gas turbine. It's practically a jet engine.
Wow.
You switch to the gas turbine.
Okay.
And you go as fast as 25 to 30 knots.
Magkano ba ang gasoline allowance niyo?
Yun lang.
It's in our budget. And then this ship right now, we more or less already have computations. And thanks to the government, we already have a budget for that for the next 2 years.
CODOG. Good. On gas, you can reach from Philippine Navy headquarters, Sulu, in how many hours?
Well, that depends also.
We
haven't tried it yet. But again, it's not advisable to run that far.
On full speed.
On full speed.
Yeah.
A lot of factors that will be involved. Okay. The sea state again, and you're pushing it to the limit.
Pushing it to the limit. All right. Well, full steam ahead for the Philippine Navy. Obviously,
yes.
Tomorrow we'll all be
Congratulations.
Excited.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
So, ano palang tomorrow is commissioning ba? Tama ba?
No, this is just a welcome ceremony.
Welcome pala.
Not yet christening.
Not yet christening. Not yet commissioning.
Because you want it.
We have to go through the process.
Yeah. Maybe you'd like to come out with a contest to find out kung sino pangalan dapat ang mananalo. Hindi
well,
pala Gregorio Del Pilar.
That's a good idea.
You know,
but,
who knows? It could be called the BRP Piolo because they like actors in this country as well.
Gregorio Del
That's
Pilar,
stretching it.
Come
That's stretching
on.
It,
come on, Tony.
I was just yanking your chain, Amro.
That's stretching it.
We thank you so much,
Admiral. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
And still to come, Lea Salonga becomes the first ever Filipino recipient of the Disney Legends Award.
And IBM creates a computer that mimics the human brain. We have all the details and the rundown returns.